Our understanding of tectonic plate theory in the 60s led to the discovery of hydrothermal vents in 1977. And these underwater hot springs led to our understanding of why hydrothermal vents are some of the most biologically active areas in the deep sea, a process known as chemosynthesis.
Humans, of course, think that these habitats are very extreme by our standards.
That's Dr. Shana Goffredi, an associate professor of biology at the Occidental College and co-chief scientist aboard Schmidt Ocean Institute's Falkor in the Gulf of California.
I'm Brittany, a Schmidt Ocean Institute science communications intern in Brooklyn.
Scientists discovered chemosynthesis in the bottom of the ocean in the deep sea, but it actually happens in many locations on the planet. So it was one of those situations where you had to go to the deepest depths to discover something that's actually quite common.
At these hydrothermal vents, this process called chemosynthesis is happening. But what exactly is it? Well, let me break it down. Photosynthesis powers 99% of the Earth's ecosystems. Plants, algae, and some bacteria convert carbon dioxide and water into carbohydrates, using the energy from sunlight, leaving oxygen behind as a byproduct. Chemosynthetic processes are different from photosynthetic ones because chemosynthesizers use energy released from chemical reactions instead of the sun's energy. These energy producers turn mineral-rich hydrothermal fluid into organic compounds. Both photosynthesis and chemosynthesis are processes called primary production, where organisms create their own food for energy. They are the foundation of all life on this planet, and we wouldn't be here without primary producers. Microbes like bacteria and archaea. Archaea are like bacteria's cousins. Do this work of converting these inorganic compounds into organic compounds. Even microbes gotta make a living. So these chemosynthetic bacteria are the foundations of the entire food web here. Hydrothermal vents and the process of chemosynthesis play a larger role in the ocean as well.
So chemosynthesis relies on quite a few biogeochemical cycles. We really kind of only think about this narrow metabolic capability of us. We have to consume organic carbon and we have to breathe oxygen, but most microbes don't have to do either of those things, and they are contributing to making the planet livable for more fragile life forms, which I would include humans in that grouping.
I know, biogeochemical is a mouthful, but biogeochemistry is an awesome field of science. It essentially means looking at the planet as a system, is studying the Earth's most abundant nutrients and how their chemical cycles flow through living and non-living things, biology and geology. It's the literal circle of life. These vents aid in regulating the ocean's chemistry by adding and removing elements. Scientists believe that the entirety of the world's oceans cycle through these vents every 10 to 20 million years. Nature itself recycles. Photosynthesis powers 99% of the Earth's ecosystems. But that 1% is still pretty important for the biogeochemistry of the planet.